All right, we are in our strategic plan van. We're headed to our first destination. I wonder where we're going. Yay! We're at Wilbur Middle School. Let's go in and see what we can find. I am here today at Wilbur Middle School, and I am here with Mr. Littlefield and Ms. Isaac. And I am here to learn about what they are doing to champion the strategic plan. So tell me about what you're doing.
So we've been working with Project Lead the Way, the curriculum, and we received some VEX equipment about 3 or 4 years ago, and that kind of set us off to work with VEX Robotics and introduce the VEX Robotics competition to our students. That led us also to Girls Who Code and Girls Who Build. So we're just trying to lead them towards the technology skills that might lead them into one of these STEM fields, whether it's manufacturing or a STEM career in computer science. We want to excite them in the middle school to engage them in that field.
So this is all about choices and opportunities for our kids. Could you tell us a little bit about what these skills will be able to do as they transition to maybe the feeder pattern school at Northwest High School?
At Northwest, they have an excellent new program in aviation, and they have Google IT classrooms over there that even leads to certifications for them that they can get right out of high school and be certified to get into a career right away.
And this also links in to our strategic plan about increasing the amount of certifications that our students leave with when they graduate from us from high school. So this is an awesome opportunity for our kids to have choices to be able to determine what they'd like to do in the future. So tell me, what do the kids really like about this class?
So the students really get hands-on experience where they get to build, they actually get to use screws, they get to use figure out gear ratios, mechanical advantage. They get to learn all of those engineering principles in a hands-on space where they get to build and create. That is the main thing that we're trying to get them excited about, is creating.
And then they take their unique project, their robot, and they go and compete. And it's the competition piece that is so motivating for the students.
Awesome. So tell me, I know that you've gone and competed before, and I know that you've had the opportunity to expose kids. Tell me how they've done and what kind of excitement do you see from them at the competitions?
The competitions are where the excitement and where, I mean, they get more learning done in the 4 hours of a competition than they do in maybe the 3-4 weeks before that in class. Just because they're able to see what other students are doing, they're able to collaborate and work with the team to see what other people are building. What is somebody else doing that I could do better?
And that's what learning is all about. And that's the environment that we have in the Wichita Public Schools, empowering our kids to dream, to believe, and achieve. I think it's time for us to talk to some kids. What do you think?
Yeah.
So can you tell me, what are you guys doing here? This seems like a lot of stuff going on. What's happening?
Right now we're just fixing up the robot. We're making sure that the ports are nice and organized so that in a competition, the robot won't get caught up in the cords so that the cords won't rip also.
Okay, so you're preparing yourself for competition, right? So how many of you have already gone to competition?
Me.
You all have gone? Okay, so tell me about the competition and what all happens at that competition, and what was the outcome of you all going to the competition?
Last year we had a whole different setup, and so it was a lot different, but we actually didn't do that well because we learned that we shouldn't use steel, and so going to competition makes you learn what you need to use or not to use.
Oh, so what competition was this year was an opportunity to kind of see what everyone else is doing and learn a lot of skills that you may not have learned in class, then that way that makes you better for next time.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what learning is all about. So tell me about how you and what is the best part about being in this class?
Hands-on activities, I would say.
Hands-on activities. Okay, let's think about that. So you're learning all these cool skills. What are you going to do with all these skills in the future?
I would use them in our knowledge, going through high school, or use it as a class in college to pursue. like engineering.
Awesome. So you think you might want to be an engineer? That's cool. And I think this is a perfect pathway for you to be able to do that. Tell me about this Girls That Code and Girls That Build. What is that all about?
So Girls That Build is basically something that we do with Textron Aviation. And we have lunch and we talk about like engineering, Textron, and like Girls That Code, you learn a bunch of cool stuff about coding and like how to use it properly. And that really helps with our robots because obviously we do have to code our robots and we need to make sure that they're ready.
That's awesome. So we want to thank Textron, right? For being such good partners in helping us to be able to get our students prepared for the future. So that's really awesome. You guys are amazing. You are why we do what we do every day, to make you all be the best that you can be so that you can go out and be that engineer and you can go out and do anything that you want to do. So thank you for allowing me in your space. And I guess I'll stay out of the way so you guys can continue on. I want to thank all the staff and the students at Wilbur Middle School. And who knows, I may be at your school next. Bye.